Arsene, we live in a very conservative society, but you appear to be a non-conformist. You don't conform to the rules of Armenian society, because I've seen you in different characters and different roles on the stage, singing, acting, and you're kind of crazy.
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe.
Or kind of insane.
Okay, one notch higher than crazy. Where does that come from?
I can say it's come from my nature, from who am I, and from there how I understand. I understand myself, like who am I and where am I and what I am doing. And then when I understood that I'm living in this earth and this whole world made from humanity, from humans, I got like, I don't want to be, it doesn't matter, like now I'm in Armenia and we have some conservative society, and for example, like somewhere there is a very different society. I understood that the people are same everywhere, with their feelings, with their emotions, and maybe it came from my profession, from my what I'm doing, or. But I can say it's more from my nature, because I used to try to control myself, to bring myself like in kind of roads, to be more more like that, like the society wants to see you. It doesn't help me.
Well, thankfully, because you're one of the talented, young Armenians in Armenia that give people like myself who are on the other side of the television screen or the movie screen or during, you know, a concert or a play that give us great pleasure, because, you know, our lives are really tough in Armenia most of the time. There's a lot of peer pressure, especially with the young boys and guys and men, right? They do ask you to conform to a certain model of what they think an Armenian man should be. But absolutely, we are human beings at the end of the day, whether we live in New York or Taiwan or Yerevan, right? So,
definitely.
But were you, growing up, I can imagine your mom. I mean, were you crazy then too? Like, were you like a very active kid?
I remember the story they told me what I did when I was really little child, and I remember already that things what I am remembering, like when I was little and did that things. But my mom, my parents gave me the freedom. Of course, with their correcting something, you know, you don't need to be like this or in this way. But you know, whole picture, like they give me that feelings, like I'm free and I'm free to do what I want to do. I believe, and that's fact. Nothing is same in this creating world. Yeah. I mean, everything is different, and also the people are very different, mm-hmm. and very different. So,
yeah, as parents, we oftentimes try to inject our own sort of views and worldviews on our children. But you guys, after all, have to figure out what you want to do so that you're happy in your own skin. Because if they had forced you to be an engineer or a lawyer, or would you have been happy? You know, it's a question you ask ourselves.
My father is engineer.
Okay, there you go. I didn't know.
When they understood that I want to be an actor, my father have very serious conversation with me, and he's like,
Dras,
in Armenia. It's like insane. It's crazy to go there because, for example, like you can work and buy for you like pack of cigarette or something like that, so you need to become I don't know, doctor, lawyer,
something,
or
yeah, sure,
like, very strong.
But it is a tough profession, isn't it, acting in Armenia, anywhere? But
I think it's tough profession, but it's for me it's more fun than tough.
Yeah, well, that's good. Yeah.
I don't know, but I have that feelings like I was born here, and I'm working here, I'm working here in the theater, I'm in movie sets, but I know like this profession is kind of you feel where you are, you feel from where you are, and you feel everything what is happening, what's going around. But more it's like you're opening your like the view, how you see this life, how
sure.
you feel the other people, mm. your friends, sure. your colleagues.
Yeah, yeah. You were born in the early 80s. At a time when Armenia was still part of the Soviet Union.
Yes.
And I'd like to ask this question to my guests who were born in the Soviet era, who have some memories, obviously, of the earthquake and then the Karabakh War and independence and that huge transformation that the country went through. You were a young boy at the time, but you must have seen how your parents struggled. How has the progression of Armenia been for you?
When I was in Soviet Union, I remembered, like, for me, that's amazing part of my life. When I buy matches, because it's in that time it was cost like 1 ruble or something like that. Like it was very cheap, like as now. So I bought a lot of box of matches, and I made the. Seeing some decorate something
for like a play, right?
Like a play, and that was like my childhood's more amazing toy to play. That
yeah.
was
and memories.
And memories.
I've heard a lot from your generation the memories that they have of potatoes roasting on those stove, you know, the wood stoves that everybody had to buy. To heat their homes in the early 90s.
Oh, but yeah, in that time I was like a little bit, I was 8 or 9 years old, maybe. I didn't feel the hard part of that kind of life because as a child I felt like, now it's cold, but I feel warmness because in that time everyone's like, looks like our old building, it seems like we are one family and we are all living together. We are sharing what we have because sharing is caring. And so for me, it's not like I didn't broke. I remember I had the fears till like maybe years ago. I just leave it or I just
mm-hmm. You let it go.
Yeah, I let it go. I had the fears from darkness. For example, when I used to go to the bathroom, I asked my mom to stand the other side of the door. But that was like, I mean, I remember a lot of beautiful things. I remember all my neighbors, they came in our house or we were in their house and like you can knock the everyone's door and ask for everything. And. Of course, that time we don't have the everything.
But whatever you had, you shared
yeah.
with one another.
Yeah.
And now?
And now, but I can say I keep and I'm working on it to keep that character, right? What I see in my childhood. So, I think if you have something, you can share it with people because this. Life is very beautiful for me because of people, because of human beings.
That's
because
right.
They are all amazing. They are all amazing. A lot of them, they don't know about it.
They haven't figured it out yet, right?
Yeah, they
searching for the goodness.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I'm like, I'm very friendly. I can became a like as a friend or. As a person who can do something for it.
Somebody else.
Somebody else. Yes, Kortreti Ashkatanke, Imigani Amitsarach,
Well, Arsen, you know, I've heard from many people, and obviously we've seen you before. You're a very talented actor, but you also sing. So, you know, as you said, you've been in theater and in movies. You've produced songs, the Abba Gudde song, yeah. I remember vividly. Because I think you also did it, you did Abba Gudde and then you did Ipeng Kim, yeah, right? It was the Eastern Armenian, Eastern and Western Armenian versions of the Armenian alphabet. And I loved it because, you know, as a Western Armenian, I always had difficulties trying to speak Eastern Armenian here. What is your favorite thing to do? What is the thing that really gives you immense joy?
Live.
Okay.
Live on
You can
stage,
say all of them,
stage.
But I...
no, my favorite thing is acting. It's when I'm in theater or in a movie, my favorite thing, because in that time I'm really like feeling like this is, I'm doing that what I love to do or what I have to do maybe.
But what a blessing, right? To be able to work and do what you love to do.
That's why I became a happy person. And now I'm happy, really, because I love my job. Everyone is creating something. Or someone creating the bad mood, or the other one is creating the good mood.
Yeah, it's a process of creation, regardless
yeah, it's
if
like it's... for me, this life is a process of creation. So that's why I'm really happy.
You also have something called Kami Blog.
Kamel blog, yes.
Kamel blog? What is that? Please tell me.
Why check podcast niche karam spasel meres handip mane.
She's very funny.
Yeah, you take on a role of a woman.
Of a woman, yes.
Which our male actors seem to love to do in Armenia. But that's a conversation for another day. So, where was the inspiration for that?
Praise God, like the only characters made in that. It became, it was 2013 as I remember, and here was the competition for Miss Armenia. And so, but that show which is gone before that main show, the final show where they checked, so the casting, like who is coming, we watched that show on TV, and there's really girls, I think they can do a lot of good things but not became a Miss Armenia.
I can't believe you said that.
Մի պահ կարծես հրաժեշտ էի տվել հեռուստատեսությանը, մեկ ասում եմ վերադառնա, մեկ էլ մտածում եմ, բայց Կամիլ, գուցե քեզ այլևս ոչ ոք չի սպասում.
Okay.
So,
I love your take on life.
So with the 32 production, we just like having fun, mm-hmm. And that character is became like it was something improvisation.
Okay.
So when we put that program, which is changing your face,
right.
To became more that kind of girls who can do everything, and other things, not the one. When I saw her monitor, like, and I said, oh gosh, like, immediately I find her voice, mm-hmm. what kind of voice she's speaking, mm-hmm. and kind of like the way of thinking, maybe it's a more common character in Armenia, like the girls we have who love that. Oh,
the titties girls?
The titties girls, maybe. The beautiful girls, because Camille thinking she's very beautiful.
Okay. Well, okay, we won't delve any further into her brain then. How is that? Do you have big dreams, Arsen? Do you see yourself on bigger stages and bigger movie screens?
Yes. I do. I remember when I was a child, in that time I thought like, you're gonna see that day will come and I'm gonna be like the big stages and do the big projects. Like, I'm gonna be the, like, in Aria is beautiful actors and actresses are playing. I'm gonna play. I have dreamed to be on set with Meryl Streep.
Okay, yeah, I think we've all dreamed that. Yeah. but no, I'm. But soon.
But I remember, I don't know why, maybe because of kind of society, because of the, a lot of things happened to me. Before, I remember when I lost my dreams. And I thought like, okay, like, forget about it, because it's, no one's gonna believe you, and everyone's like looking to you like,
yeah, okay, right, yeah.
Poor guy, poor guy.
Full of all these dreams, yeah. Right?
But once I understood that I don't wanna afraid of my dreams, and now I'm making my dreams as bigger as I can imagine, and the same time I can't imagine. And I have that dreams, and I mean, that day is near.
Yeah.
I was in New York last year, so it was Christmas time. I was there, and I'm standing on the corner. So there's a red light. So I was there like 2 months already, and I'm asking myself and like the universe and God, but like as I started, okay, Arsen, what do you want? What are you doing here? And I'm like, I want to be in American production, like the movie, and I want to see the way how they're working, all that stuff. And it's like someone showed me like, do you understand when you're saying movie in America what it's mean? It's not Armenia like once in a year or twice in a year. It's like we have the from soap operas to the independent movies and everything. And I said, I want to be in some independent movie, and it doesn't matter. It's a famous the director or actors in it or something like that. But I want to be in that in the independent movie, because as an actor I feel that, like, I want to be in that, because I don't know. But so after 2 days I got call from my friend Mako, and he's like, I want to introduce you one of my friends, and he's now in a movie, and there's a role, like, it's not the main character, it's supporting character, and there's a character from Armenian Taxi Driver. And it's an independent movie, and the director is, so he's known in New York, he's known, like, movie moms or kino moms, how can I say? And I said, yes, okay. So we had to meet, and I just learned drive, like, I didn't drive before that.
Okay.
So funny.
You don't know how to drive in it, you're going for a roll of it.
I didn't say that, no. That like I can't drive.
Yeah.
And like I learned the one day before the shooting day. So, and the other day is like my first day when I'm without the coach. Like
Yeah, without a driving instructor.
And I'm driving, and I remember the, after the shooting, I got when director is sitting here, and like I just learned to drive, and there's light from here, and camera is from here, and I used to withdraw that Hollywood, San Fernando Boulevard, in that like it's really very busy.
Yeah,
very busy. So and like at the end of the shooting day, I said like, you know, I just learned. How to drive yesterday. And they're like, what? I think they're like they afraid kind of.
Yeah,
like,
that you didn't.
Got the shirt.
They got you didn't kill anybody.
We are alive. And that was an amazing experience. And I'm waiting for this movie, but maybe in September it will come out. And I believe in that kind of things which is happening during our lives.
Sure.
And sometimes usually the now like year or 2 year, I don't know, after 30 or something like that, that's what I'm sharing with people. I'm like, you know, this life is ready to give you the amazing surprises, like to make
be open to them.
Be open to them.
Yeah.
And when you are open to them, blessings is always
absolutely
coming.
Absolutely. It's what you emit to the universe and it gives it back to you. And there's no such thing as a coincidence. There's always a reason for things. Arsene, you know, I will be watching you with great joy and pleasure to see where your dreams take you. Whether that's in Armenia or in Hollywood or in Bollywood or wherever your journey leads you. Thank you. Thank you for
thank you very
talking
much.
With us. It was a great pleasure.
Thank you very much. It was amazing to talk to you. Talking to you. And I have one dream, you know about it. That's the other movie.
The other movie.
Yeah.
We'll be keeping our fingers crossed. We'll leave that as a secret.
Thank you
and we'll
very
see what
much.
Thank you.